matchup.
So
and good. I 100% almost can guarantee we're gonna see the fast fall opener from Dogs. Yeah, just get on the ground. He loves finding that like early grab in this matchup.
Was with that, a downer regrab.
Yeah, that fourth throw downer is one of like the sort of innovations that Dogs has made in this matchup. I mean, other people have done it, but he's kind of the person who's really pushed it to where like now other Falcons are just simply copying it because it seems to be the best option against modern DI.
Oh, I've always been a fan of the no aerial, just F throw into F throw.
Yeah, that's a good one too.
I think you can actually do any aerial after the forward. Ogg's definitely making a strong case for Dare.
Yeah,
ooh,
the thing.
Look at that though.
Oh, nice.
Air shield drop up air.
The thing with the forward throw downer is you can't DI up high enough to stop the downer from spiking you.
What is that? So... Did you see that F tilt plank with jab? What? Never
yeah.
in my life seen that.
So I think maybe the F-tilt just hit, like connected with the hitbox, but not the hurtbox, because it should just be the jab.
It's just such a weird interaction. It's like they're playing Street Fighter. Ooh, light punch straight into the light.
The invincibility was still there.
Oh, just barely outspaces and you see that panic DI from Doug.
Crazy distance. And he goes for the forwarder and it's just not as good as the downer. You just go for the downer these days, or else it'll DI up.
Oh, so careful. This is not those crazy Janko Falcon Dittos that we saw before. They're both playing so precise. Using their whole moveset. Trying to optimize
finds
everything.
Another grab.
Finds that dare, can't DI it. This should be the kill.
Yeah, I mean, he just got this combo down so well. Exactly, he says in the chat, late dare, react to DI, right? Because it can only DI left or right, so you just need to either like dash grab or turnaround grab or a standing grab, and it's simply
yeah, and
reactable.
By doing the dare late, you just get give yourself that maximum amount of time, you know?
Yeah, so Goon contemplating a bit here if he wants to counterpick.
He's shown at least four different characters throughout the course of this tournament. Really have to wonder which is going to be the best choice to use.
Really?
This,
like,
Falcon.
Taking
could
his
play
time
the Kirby.
Here.
Play Fox, Pikachu.
He's following his heart and picking Fox. So Doug's
right.
up 1-0 here.
Fights his way to grand finals, and this is what he's gonna bet it on. Bet it on the Fox.
It wasn't feeling the Falcon, did it?
I don't blame him. Dogs. Hard to see who can beat Dogs in the Falcon, did it, really? Defeated Zero at Super Smash Con. He's always been very confident in his skills in that matchup.
Oh, big up
Dogs
smash.
And Kira played the Falcon Dittos. Kira's very good.
Oh,
ooh,
what?
I wonder if he could up smash there.
He definitely could have up smashed there. He wanted to extend the combo onto the side.
Why'd he jab? What are these jabs? Just down smash,
oh,
right?
No.
Is that 130%?
Yeah, I think he's just, you know, he's just vibing. He's doing what he knows.
I mean, the jab's cool. Feels like down smash. I don't know. Ooh, the down tilt. Nice DI there.
Get back on with the back air.
Making it as hard as possible for him.
So safe. And then... misses the tech chase. Barely.
Even on stocks here.
Oh, Dogs just fell
but
off.
But he's no jump.
That's
he's so
it.
Far off.
He should just kill off of this.
Just F tilts him.
Oh,
down smash,
no.
But this time it sends him the wrong way. That situation.
Okay.
So tough.
Big F throw. Yeah, Dogs isn't even gonna try. Knows when he's not got anything left in the tank on the recovery.
Yeah. Well, that up air though, since he has a bit of percent. Ooh, you see how far he spaces away, knows that Dogs could do that up smash or grab out a shield and doesn't want to get hit by it. Dogs respecting it and doesn't throw it out. See just how high level both these guys are. Their awareness of these options.
Oh, Goon is looking so comfortable right now.
Finds his edge guard, really proving that Fox might have been the right choice here.
The thing is though, even if he does take this game, Dogs has that Pikachu counter pick and a whole
yeah.
set of cushion to work with being on the winner's side of things.
I it's so nice to be the one on winner's side and winning that game one in these situations where both sides have multiple counterpicks available. Yeah, weird. I like crouch cancel, especially at low percents.
Dogs is starting a comeback.
A fair! That this catches him and suddenly it's last stock.
It's not even, it's completely even. Like, Fox can just blow up.
He hasn't even taken any lasers.
Okay, tech chase, yes.
He got those last stocks.
Oh,
so
and
quickly.
The patience. He's confident in his tech chase.
Oh, but he calls him out. He assumes he's going on stage.
Okay, that's a big back throw. Down tilting into the forwarder, that's gonna do it. Oh, he got his jump! But it's still enough.
And he knows to hog the ledge. That was really ambiguous.
Yeah, so Goon evening it up 1-1. What the fuck?
These situations where both players are so capable with counter picks.
It looks like they're just sticking with it.
It was pretty close. It was a nice comeback there from Dogs, but man. Looks surprised he doesn't go with the Pikachu. I mean, he looked strong in Pikachu Fox earlier.
He does the 2014 combo and Goon doesn't DI out.
I probably didn't expect it. That's the thing with some of those old combos, you know? It's like, no one does them and suddenly they can be good. I like that up B positioning, but Fox just waits for it. And he's just taking two stocks without even being hit. Against an opponent with a laser gun. There's gonna be three stocks without being hit. Look at this.
Oh man. Don't JV. 0%.
0%.
No perfects, please.
Fox.
Not in grins. Okay. He got the laser.
Air on stage. He says, no, I'm hitting you. Even
he got the laser. Now we'll see if he can get the whole game back out of the clutches of Dogs Johnson.
I like this edge guard. Hits him with a little laser. Hits him with that up angled F tilt. Boon. Not getting sloppy despite being so far behind. These respawns, man, just gets hit by it. I felt like against KD3-2, the respawn invincibility is really proving to be a challenge for
That was a comp
Goon.
In the game from Dogs and Goon. Trying the Kirby here, a classical counter pick, if there ever were one.
Yeah, so betting the tournament on this, if he loses, this is his final game. It starts to feel like is starting to run out of tricks in the tank, you know.
Yeah. And yeah, this is the matchup that Dogs has put a lot of time into. A matchup that, in fact, like, I've put time into with Dogs on labbing, and I know that he knows a lot about this. He's very good, he's very patient. It's the same thing, you know, as we saw against the Puff earlier. Dogs is, like, prepared for these.
He finds that back air.
Floaty matchups, and he knows how to just abuse Falcon's properties against these characters. You see his game plan, he's very aerial, right? But then he can just find those grabs and...
Oh! One off up air there could have been another zero.
Dogs is just seeming to be on fire right now, looking unstoppable.
Oh, Goon misses the ledge.
Goon
That's
might
so
just
rough.
Be out of steam here.
It's tough when you have to play through that massive loser's bracket for hours, you know?
Yeah, and just like maybe not as much patience as you want to see from the Kirby, because like here we are a minute into the match.
He keeps attacking him on top platform, which is just not how you win this matchup with Kirby.
But yeah, Goon was very tired, I've heard.
I can't blame him.
I know he's been going to bed at like 9 or 10 o'clock, and you know, this tournament ran until 12 or so.
Just catches
very
him with
much.
A hard read of the.
Past his bedtime, and Dogs is gonna clean it up here, looking
sending him to bed.
In this bracket. He dropped one game to Goon and one game to Baba Ganoush, and other than that, just kind of cleaned everyone up.